Finally.
Yeah.
A warm welcome to you, Nisa, on Madhvi's Luxury Cook Dot. And pleasure to have you with us. So finally, guys, she's here. And thank you, everyone, for keeping the patience. And to Shalini for informing that we were going to probably wrong. And now we are here, all of us together. So, a great evening to everybody on the live show. And just brief a bit about Lisa. Lisa Verma is a show director and production consultant for School Talent Management, Times of India, to groom Miss India contestants and train Miss World Anushi Diller. One of India's leading show director, she has directed and managed over 2,500 fashion and luxury lifestyle events in India and overseas. That's something awesome, wonderful. So it's a real pleasure and honor to have you here with us today, Lisa. And would love to know your story and your journey.
I started very early in life from Calcutta. I was a school girl at the age of 16 when I first started doing a little bit of modeling. There was some ad which was in the newspaper, and some of us friends, we used to live in the army area actually. So we decided to, all go together and try for, modeling. And we got a chance and we started modeling there. And I started joining a number of contests like army club contest, DSY, May Queen, all those kind of stuff in Calcutta used to happen also. So we joined a number of contests, and then I started getting a lot of praises from all my friends and family, and they said, why don't you try for the India for the films. So I joined for the Feminine Miss India, and luckily I was Miss Calcutta, and then I went for the Miss was my partners. And in the meantime, I got a few offer of films. I did 3 Bengali movies, out of which one got released, and then really come.
Okay.
Also in Hindi films, in fact, we lost Rishi Kapoor a few days back. He offered Rahul Ravel, we called Beta, which was starting that time. They had called me for the did. But somehow I was not very happy with the film industry, and I wasn't very comfortable because in Canada only when I was doing people are shaken off by the elder directors and producers, asking me to come in the evening for their meetings, come for script reading and all that in their house and things like that. So I was a little uncomfortable. Got married at a very early age, and got married and had a runaway marriage. Then I had my first child, and then I had my second child. In between, in Calcutta, I started doing some corporate jobs because I was not wanting to the industry or other, glam. I wouldn't call it fashion at that time. It was more of glamour and more like the film industry. So I did Taj Group of films. I work for Alitalia, I work for Citibank, and then the whole and we had wanted to, by then we shifted to Delhi also. So my sister came, was a young girl, and she wanted to just make her meet the photographer, whoever she wanted to make the portfolio with. And then the photographer said, going to give me work. I've got 2 kids, and I don't think I'm going to fit into this industry at all. So he said, let me make your portfolio, and then we'll see how it goes. So I made my portfolio with us, and Vidya had done my makeup. I did not have to look back. I started getting a lot of ads, and commercial, television ads, and this. I met you around that time because you were married.
Reception, and everybody was like, who's this beautiful lady who came for your reception? I still remember.
So that's how it all started. Then I modeled in Delhi for about 5 years. During that time, Shushmita was going for a Miss India contest. She was a neighbor, and she was a very dear friend of my sister, actually her best friend. So So she used to keep coming to the house, and I felt that she was very, she joined the She also took it very coolly and, you know, not very interested in it. She said, okay, I'll help you. And then, you know, like, all through her journey, I helped her a lot in all the question answers, the walking and the introduction and all that. She's right. Always been very cool to me on that. Then, at that time, till 1999. And then I got tired of modeling all the time. And I said, let me try something else. And the big time,
can you come a bit closer, because I hope the audience is able to listen us clearly. Can you just text if you're not able to hear us or something? Are you guys able to hear us clearly? Yeah. If you can be a little closer to the mic or the network area, Lisa, a bit.
Sure. Yeah, sure, sure. Can you hear me now?
Very clear. Now it's much better. Yeah.
So then after that, that's my friend Malvinder. He's, I think, somewhere in Bahrain. He's my college school time friend. He's also saying hi. So, in Delhi, I said that let me just try this choreography bit once again. So a couple of my friends from my modeling industry, I would say Swarina Singh, she was the first one who did a shoot with me for Driving Car. She said, Lisa, I'll introduce to the whole industry, why don't you do it? And then there's this lady who's had a shop called Silver Tulip. She used to be under the Defense Colony flyover. She used to be the lady who used to be actually doing choreography all our shows in Calcutta. So she used to meet me in Gymkhana Club a lot, and she said, Lisa, you do my show. So she's the first one who gave me an offer to do her show in the Gymkhana Club. That was the first ever fashion show in Gymkhana Club. And it was a super success. And I worked with the top models, there was Jay, there was Meher Basi, Ruchi Malhotra. So I had the top models, Anna Kumar. All of them did their show. I still remember Pujan, my backstage manager, was very, very helpful. And, you know, like, after that, I really didn't have to look back, honestly speaking. So, I had a partner those days called Jaspreet. He used to be a model also. We did the show together. Then we did an auto expo show, which was also helped. I remember very clearly, Kitika Ganju had helped us on to get that event for, Hero Honda motorcycle. I really look back. I went and met some, Times of India people, and, you know, they gave me superb coverage in Femina. So, you know, media really helped me a lot. And one by one, you know, it was all my industry, my photographers, my models who I worked with as models, my makeup artists, they started, you know, suggesting that why don't you take Lisa. Then a lot of designers have been very helpful. I would especially like to mention Mr. Sunil Sethi, the FBI president, who gave me the chance to be a member and start with the FBI. It was very, very helpful. So all these, I'd like to also mention another person named called Mr. Rajan Madhu, who was very, very helpful. He used to be owning FBI India. But what overseas, I went for FDCI shows overseas. So all these helped me, and you know, I learned over the time, and then I got interested in doing exhibitions. So I launched my own exhibition in Toronto and in Paris. I did the first ever our show in Paris. Then I got a chance to have my own event in Toronto called Jashan Toronto, where I took Anju Modi and Shyamal Vivekananda, which was a super success. Then I did a show in Australia with a very nice set of designers. This way, you know, I carried on doing all this. At Dubai, I did a lot of shows. And then I got into pageant grooming for the last 3 years now. I was part of the Times of India shoot talent management. That is also, I'd like to thank Ila Kumar Walia. She's the one who put me on board from Times of India. So this way, you know, like, a lot of people have been very helpful, and I'm very thankful that God been very, very kind to me, and, you know, work happened. I worked very hard, no doubt. And my biggest achievement is, of course, Manushi Chinder. She won the contest, and she made me so proud, and she talked about me in the night. Till now, she called me up. Few days back, she called me up, you know, it was so sweet. She called me up to find out how I'm doing in the lockdown. So it's very nice, you know, such lovely people, Shushmita, Neha, Isha, they're all such wonderful people. They always thank me, Kalina, Grani, they're all lovely people, and I think I'm very grateful. I've been very
grateful. Absolutely, awesome. So it's been a very, very exciting life and journey for you, and, you know, a lot of, like, you got a lot of exposure, a lot of experience, a lot of, you know, evolving all through. And
yeah,
I believe it came in you naturally, because being from an army background, I think girls are very well cultured, well mannered, and it comes very naturally to them. There's no trainer in those times, I believe, to train you for Mrs. India or Mrs. World. And it's been very nice to hear from you. You've been so honest about the casting couch in the film industry, which has been there relevant even in those times and now also. And you have a choice.
It was very bad. It was very bad. People are smart nowadays. Our girls are very smart. You know, our children are very smart. We were very innocent. We had no idea what the person actually wanted to tell us.
Yeah. And I think you always have a choice to decide whether you want to be going there, and you know, it's your choice and wish whether you continue to be in the industry despite of that, or you choose to do something else, like how you decided and carried on. And I think you've done a great work all these years, and it's amazing to know that you managed over 2500 fashion and luxury lifestyle events in the country and abroad as well. So if I may know, which has been your favorite show so far among all these?
I would say, you know, the Eiffel Tower Paris, that was the first ever French European Indian Fashion Week, which happened in the Eiffel Tower. It was the most iconic event to ever happen. And we had taken the biggest designers from the country, and they were designers from France and, you know, like England and all of Europe. So it was the most achieving show of my life, for sure.
Right. And from the shows, now you're also into exhibitions in Toronto, right? You do also
exhibitions. Yes, I'm doing exhibitions in Toronto. It all happened because the lockdown, it's all closed now. There was another big exhibition coming up in London. So I've now, you know, like, since I do exhibitions for the last 5 years, and I help other companies in Vancouver. There's a very good company, Indian designers. Parvesh and Jay, they started first thing in Vancouver, so I started helping them to get the designers on board. So now, you know, everybody knows that I do exhibitions, so people are all, you know, calling me and finding out when is your next exhibition, where is your next exhibition. And I'm tying up with different people from different countries who are based in those countries, and they're strong in their country to get the, you know, like, local things done. Because sitting in India, you cannot organize a venue, you know, production, everything all together. So we have a local partner. Other country, it helps you a lot. So we collaborate together and do the event.
Right. So more into collaborations internationally now, different countries.
Yeah. I'm very keen to take Indian fashion go global. You know, that's my main, and especially the ones who are newer, who are unable to go. Because see, the Fashion Design Council of India, I'm a member for 16 years, but there are a limited number of people who are members, and many people cannot become members. So the whole idea is to take Indian fashion to a different level, and, you know, help the younger, very talented designers who are, may not have money or whatever it is, you know, that much of money to pitch in for big time events and things like that. So you may as well help them to take them to different countries and show them a new world, actually.
Yeah, get that experience and exposure to them as well. That's really nice. And you also have a visa modeling acting academy for students, right?
Where
exactly is that academy, and do you groom them for Mrs. and Miss World and India, or what exactly do you do in the academy?
So this academy is in Gurgaon itself, and I operate from my basement now. And I started at a school called, I have a branch there also. It is called the World Ravnath World School. So I have a good number. I used to also train in a couple of other, you know, like institutes like Frankfurt Indian Modeling and Acting School. I was trained there all for years. Now I decided to, you know, train myself. And after Manushi won, you know, she encouraged me a lot. She said, ma'am, why didn't you open an academy of your own? She has assessed a couple of students. All my girls, Madhavi, I'm so glad and thankful. They're all winning, you know, Femina, Miss India, Miss Diva, or the Femina Stylist. So there are a lot of girls who are trained by me who are all regularly winning every year. So that is one thing I think is my forte, to train and groom people, because I see talent and I know how to divert them in the right direction. If a person is good for acting, I'll tell her you go for acting. If a person is good for television, I'll tell her you go accordingly. When I see the modeling caliber, and moreover, I have my own shows. The best is that when I have my academy, it's not that after training them, I think they'll go and tell them that you figure it out how to make your own. I give them work myself. I do casting myself continuously, and I also do myself. So that I'm going to spend money, join a course, after joining a course, you have to help them to make a career. No point, you know, taking them out of a contest, not that's giving right. them a career.
That's right. So that's even more good for them, because if they're coming, they also get that exposure of acting and modeling and all that with you, along with doing their course. It's not that you just leave them, complete, finish your course, and there's nothing for them to look forward Absolutely. After that. So that's amazing.
Yeah.
And you've also been a coach or a trainer at the Franklin Modeling and Acting School, right? So you were...
I have other coaches also. Like I have coaching in... I have Dr. Varun Katyal, I have Rita Gangwani, I have Hita Siddiqui, okay. Ronnie Kola. I have good makeup artist Ambika Pillai, the Angie Gogna. So all very good celebrities and, you know, good people are all on board with me. So they all train with me. In fact, Yuri, Sandhya Mridul, they're all on board with me to train, you know, like acting.
So the hardcore industry people all each other, together as a team.
That's the best thing, Yeah. Moreover, they can also give work. Madhvi, the other thing is like, you know, I have all these people on board. Firstly, they help them to make a career. They come and train in group because I can't do everything myself and I also have other things to do. So Absolutely. I divide the classes amongst all of them and everybody trains in their own areas.
Right. And how do you have an eye on how do you decide that this person is good to be Miss World, Mrs. World, Miss India or for something else, you know? Because I know you're very good at that.
I don't know how I really have this. I don't know, you know, at the moment I see a person, I immediately can figure out this girl is or this boy has a caliber. And also I'm very honest to the people who are unable to, you know, there are a lot of these different, pageants which are happening in this world. There are lots of these different, I would say, you know, institute where they're training and I have gone myself to train. And when I see, you know, like people are trying to fool people by making money out of them, I feel very bad. Because if I really train somebody, I would be the proudest person if the person makes it in their life, you know. That is my own, I would say, you know, firstly, achievement of life. So idea is to make sure that you find the right people and groom them in the right manner. Not that, you know, it's not that Madhuri also in today's world, a lot of people could be not necessarily very slim, trim and everything, you know, perfect body and all that. That person may become a comedian, the person might want to become a DJ, a makeup artist. So everybody has their caliber. We can open the road to a lot of people in different areas, you know.
True, absolutely. And I think you've been pretty good with it because helped Sushmita Sen, helped Manushi Chiller, so and all the people that you chose have really excelled and done amazingly good.
Yeah.
And if you can share something about the French European Indian Fashion Week at the Eiffel Tower, your experience and how did this idea came into your mind to do these kind of, you know, events internationally? I think Dubai Fashion Fiesta, Amazon Fashion Week, Dubai Fashion League.
Dubai Fashion Fiesta happened thanks to Times of India only because I was part of their I was a consultant in shoot talent management. So that time there used to be a lady called Neela Kumar Walia. She's very popular in the industry. She was heading shoot talent management. So she had to choose four different consultants from all over India. So one was myself, one was Prasad Birappa, and one was Mark Robinson. So even Jacqueline Fernandez was chosen by me to be part of this, Indian fashion film industry. So all these girls, they used to be coming and joining the shoot talent management. They used to be grooming and training them. And then they will be taken to the market and taken to the different shows. So shoot had a, Times of India had a lot of tie-up with different world's events. So Dubai Fashion was one of their events where they used to take them to India's who are winners and take an Indian film director and Indian designer. So I took all these designers, Rohit Bhatt, Rob Yates, and lots of other designers we used to take every year. Rati Pranava, Rakshana Munga, they all went.
All top designers,
well-known designers. So we also, and the Miss India's work for us all over the world. All the winners of all, each country used to be our models. So that is how I got a chance to be part of this and part of Sri Lanka event. Where Shobha Day and, you know, Hemant Lekone, they had all gone. And Paris, once again, I think by then I became very popular. 2016, I was doing a lot of events. So the organization from Paris had connected with me to collaborate with the designer from India and the models from India. They had arranged the venue and everything. So I was just I was taken as the coordinator of taking all the designers from. So it was a lucky chance, I would say. That also came through somebody in India only who told that them that, you know, Nisa can do this. And that's how I got it.
Right. Wonderful. Yeah, because, you know, your good work is visible, seen and appreciated. So people, it's also through references that you get a lot of good work. When you're doing good in the industry, a lot of people refer your name and you get good projects to do.
In our industry, it's all about goodwill. You create good relationships and you do a good job, people will remember to take you back again. Yeah, and you do one bad job and you're thrown out.
True, absolutely. And it's more of word of mouth by the right person. You know, once they know your work and you know, you're doing great justice to your work, automatically it falls in place. And how the Bridal Week Vancouver show, if you can tell something like it.
Yeah, it's very beautiful. Firstly, Vancouver and Canada is so beautiful. And you know, like, see, the thing is, like, in Canada, the third generation Indians have not come to India. So they have gone generations ahead and slowly, slowly their parents have done very well. And the third generation of fashionable, gorgeous looking Indian girls, they wear Indian, partly Indian clothes in their main function. Then they do a lot of mix and match, but they've never seen India. Even the second generation people have not come to India, but they follow Bollywood like crazy. So for their shanti, for their engagement, for all their functions, all Indian fun, they wear Bollywood. So we have taken Talu Parasha, Saman John, Minu Tan, all these designers have been taken. They were much appreciated and they've all created a great market over there. They send them regularly, they go every year. Ambar Parijit Sahai, they've all done so well. You know, Art Carrot, they've all got with me.
Okay. Awesome. And if I can know about your future plans, looking at the scenario right now, are you already planning towards some virtual tours, exhibitions or shows and all that?
Madhvi, while before the lockdown was starting, I had launched my own pageant called Miss and Mrs. Gorgeous Worldwide, which was supposed to be held in May. But now it got postponed, but the event will happen whenever the lockdown opens, whenever international travel will start. And the exhibitions are also held on now, which is supposed to be happening later. But right now, we have just started an online award with a partner from Australia. He is a media guy, he's Brad. So we are starting in fashion and media awards. The lockdown six months time, whatever time, we will have a final event in Sydney. That's one thing. And I'm starting with my online model and grooming course, monthly catwalk, introduction, and so there are students coming on. So we are doing all this online already.
Institute already have these classes going on.
I'm also starting with brand promotion for different brands. See, we used to do in events brand promotion. Now a lot of brands are my regular brands. So I'm planning their strategies to launch their brand through social media.
Wonderful. And more on the digital and virtual world as of now, for some time, at least for everybody, And as you know, Lita, the program is about Madhvi's luxury code, but I would love to know the definition of luxury from you. What's luxury according to you?
Luxury quotient. Yeah. See, luxury quotient is, I think, you know, luxury is all about your whole style. You can be luxurious in your every sphere of life and how you carry yourself and the world. So luxury was my work, is all about luxury. I am specializing in promoting luxury. That's my job. So I think luxury quotient is part of my life.
Right, true. Lifestyle and luxury, yes. Wonderful, beautiful definition. It's all about.
Happy to connect with you, and if you remember that we decided to connect on this you have an international client, I remember, and we can talk about art also, you know, like going over and talked about nicely with your brands coming to India and taking Indian brands to Italy, I remember. So we'll definitely look into it in the future again.
Yes, surely. And it was a pleasure having you here. Any questions that the audience would like to ask, please feel free. Lisa is right here with us today. And Lisa, any message you would like to give to the audience?
See, my message is to be patient now, nothing else, because I definitely feel that, you know, you have to have your, what is important is to keep in the presence, as in for, you know, don't get lost, right. Don't feel that this time will not go away, it will go away. So you have to be in the mind of people, to stay in the mind of people, stay active, like the way what you are doing, Madhavi, that, you know, you are doing this in such on a regular basis. You're talking to different wonderful, each and every person that you've been, you know, interviewing have been such wonderful people and talking about their experience.
Thank you.
One should have, one has to do, keep in yourself in the picture. I mean, don't get lost and don't forget, don't think that this time will not go away and, you know, I am lost and my business is gone. Everybody is facing problems. Everybody is going through a crisis right now, especially the media and fashion. I feel grateful for my makeup artist missing, like not the mere ones, but for the helpers and the assistants and things like that. Many people's houses run on their business, so they are all getting into problem. But you didn't have to be in the present, be in his mind.
Stay positive. This will pass, I believe. And there is a question from you, for you, from Jesslyn. She wants to know what has been your most challenging project.
Well, the most challenging project, I think, was the Eiffel Tower show, because I had to take a lot of big designers for India. It was a lot of pressure, a lot of media, so it was a very, very big event. It was much covered all over the. So it was quite a
getting the permission to do a show like that there must not have been very easy, you know, to do it at the Eiffel Towers.
Definitely, yeah, it was a tough task.
Right. So wonderful. Lovely having you here on the show and lovely to catch up and connect with you, Lisa. All the best.
Thank
for
you.
Your
look forward to see you soon. Wish you all the best for your lovely Insta stories. We are loving it.
Thank you. Pleasure to have you. Okay, thanks. Bye.